Okay, so I already started this video. So you can see a lot of sheets already plotted. And so what I did is I went down into here, and I changed the date. Every time I plot sheets, I make sure it reflects the current date. Then I just zoomed extents, I hit the plot button, that brings up this window. Check that my line weight is the right. I don't have to do this the first time. Unless we're doing a full house plan, then there is one other line weight style we use for the electrical plan. In this case, the electrical plan is on the sheet with other stuff, so I can't use its own special line weight. Since the last thing I did was the same sheet size, same style, same pretty much setup, I just hit previous plot. Sheet size is correct, 36 by 24, full bleat. Excuse me, full bleat is important. This will not look right. You'll have a little red line somewhere around here showing you it's not fitting entirely if it is incorrect. Scale 1 to 1 for a layout sheet in almost all cases, unless it runs something special for a client. Hit preview. Look at it. Looks wonderful. So I'm going to come up here, hit the print button. Boom. Out she goes. And as you can see, I've gotten this far. So, and 5 is already done. But nonetheless, I'm going to hit save. It's going to ask if I want to overwrite it. I didn't change anything. So what I was doing was I was going over to my other screens and then putting all my sheets in order. And my OBS studio that's recording this is on the other screen. And I must have hit pause, but I didn't know when. So I was coming in to do all these. So I had done the general notes. I had done the site. And I was about to do main. Actually, I was going to say, okay, just keep doing that till they're done. But since we'll do a couple, just to make sure that this is reiterated, change the plot date. This is kind of a big one. Make sure that it's there. this program or not. Okay, I'm in this program. So why is it changing? Every time I hit the space bar, I'm in AutoCAD. Space bar, it turned that off. Okay, I'm going to have to go get rid of my shortcut that's doing that. That's what's causing this whole recording issue. Okay, we have changed it to something I don't use in any of my programs, really, which is page down. So I shouldn't be turning this recording on and off by accident all the time. So I'm going to go back to undo a bunch of work I did that may or may not have been recorded, and since I didn't think I was recording, certainly didn't get recorded with audio. So I'm going to undo a bunch of stuff. Maybe, yeah, a little bit. Okay, let's just get back to where we were. So, contractor had asked about a detail I have. I think I closed it already. So what I showed him real quick was, okay, the common truss detail. This says fascia C, section 4 specification. So this shows a subfascia and a shadow board, or some people just call it a fascia board. And we don't have that case. But this is just a general detail. In fact, this may be boxed off and closed. And this is mainly to demonstrate how this connection is done and what needs to be done. So the blocking, the H2.5 double top plate, basically that's really all this is describing. And so it is a common truss at top plate connection. The other stuff is sort of extraneous, you know. I don't even change the pitch to match what's going on, because then I can just throw this in the drawing, and we're good to go with a typical detail, or a standard detail. I'll close that out. Don't need to save the changes, but I'm doing it. So, let's go back to where we were, which was, it's called bell working, but that's just because it's from an old project, and I'm reusing it, and so, in doing so, I didn't change the name of this file, or I would have had to reset up all the extras and trying to save my client money because they're getting charged only for the changes that I make. So, since this is a reuse plan, that was our deal. So up here, I'm just going to copy this note, and I'll grab it from this point, and then I'm going to stick it to that piece of fascia, and then I'm just going to come in here and tell it what size this guy is. And so it is a 2 by, and I make the X's, oops, small, because it should have been top caps lock. Well, I'm looking in AutoCAD, but I was out for some reason. Oh, I was typing to the contractor answering his stuff in OneNote for his RFI number 3. And so that is a 2 by 6, and I'm just going to call it a fascia. Some people might actually say, hey, that is the subfascia, but it's kind of both. So, two-by-six fascia works for that, and that is basically because we're going to match the house. And then I think the owner is going to want to enclose this. In fact, since they are, let's go ahead and fix that. Make a little trim here, and then I can get rid of this line. And so what I need is I need a line that goes from here over. And then this would be like 3/8 material, but if I hope that that shows up in section, because it is a 1/2 inch print, wonderful. But what I need to do really is I need to extend these up because I got rid of that bottom line. And so I need to make it the thin color 60 line, or it's just going to be too close to this magenta line to even show up at a 1/2 inch scale. So there's that boxed, closed, boxed eave. I really think that he is going to make that decision so that it matches the house. So I'm going to go ahead and change it here. And then we'll be considered basically done. that, unless I'm wrong. And you wanted this one to not be close up. So there's my boxed eave. So that's done there. But what I do need to do down here is I also had a change that since I got, I was able to not have a continuous insulation on the outside since it is only a detached garage. Then, and I'm going to kill this guy. Actually, I like that one more than I like this one. So we're going to fix this other here, because I think I know what they're going to do. Offset 2. And we're going to change all of this to be a 2-inch foam. And so here, this one's going to be trimmed back. But first, I need to keep my, let's see, offset this 2 inches as well. I'm going to change my dirt patch, which is right here, as you can see, to fit in here. But it's going to be an odd shape, so I'll need another junction. So I'm just going to move this down just so I have it to match properties. Makes it easy. So then I can take this and delete it. Oops, undo. I don't want to delete that. I need to make it fit in this smaller space because now it is a 2-inch piece of foam. And now that that's there, I'm going to change this light, this line to a much lighter line, which is the object thin layer. And then between here and here, it's going to be filled with that dirt. This can go to the junk layer because I don't want it to print. But it doesn't matter if it stays there or not. So now this is all set up. Just come in here and hatch that area. It turns out it's on that junk layer. If I just do MA for match properties, click that old hatch, click this one, and that's done. Erase that. And this is fixed for that problem. Oh, did it too early though, because I guess it doesn't matter if we actually show the slough still or not. But they do want to pour this over. And so to make that happen, all I really need to do is that. Because I think the cold joint's going to be down here. So their slough may occur back here. And if I was doing a brand new plan, I'd fix that. In this case, I am trying to save our client some coin. So we're not even going to worry about it. Option 2, pour slab. Let's just put on top, it's already there, on top of stem wall. So they just want to pour it over, and I think they will pour this footing first. See if I'm right. Now we should be in good shape. So zoom the fence, and then I can hit save. And that reflect will show up here when I go to plotting. It's going to say, hey, you got to do this. And I can look, and sure enough, boom, there it is. And there's that. There's my new note. All that stuff is coming in. And it looks jaggedy like this because my REA, it smooths it out. It's just a save processing power, which this computer doesn't need. Okay. Now we're back out, and I have got my last sheet plotted was A4. This is S2. Do I have? I just want to get them all in order so I don't miss any. So I got A1, 2, 3, 4. Is not printed. A4. Oh, there it is. I just did it out of order. So A3, A4. I'm sorry, I'm on the other screen. A5. So we have got all those plotted. So I need S1. Let's just make sure that we've got them all. So I'm going to get S1. Date's good. Zoom extents. And again, we'll just hit save because I haven't built it. I hit twice sometimes. I don't know when There's my preview. I've already reviewed it. Plot. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see it there. Save. And that just showed up on the other screen. And then the last sheet. And so let's just check. Yep, that's changed. So, and now it's print. And previous again. View. And let's see, I'm jumping out at me. Let's set my lines in the right place. Mainly looking at the line weight down here. And so let me plot. Boom. And going into the folder, name is good, and those are done. So all I gotta do now is email this off to the clients and to the contractor, finish up my notes in OneNote so that it can be seen by both parties, and wait for the final word. Hopefully we are good. So that's it for this recording.